シナリオが考えられますか？
There is no Palestinian state.
Plan for post-war Gaza?
It's a document done by Americans and Israeli military people. It starts all over again, occupying Palestinian territories for the next 100 years. There will be no Palestinians left. It's enough. I want to go home.
はい、皆さんこんにちは、駐日パレスチナ総代表部パレスチナ大使館の方からお届けしております、今日もワリド大使にお話をお伺いします。ワリド大使、今日もよろしくお願いします。まあ、前回前々回と、まあ、パレスチナ、ガザ、ラファ、そういったお話を、まあ、いろいろお聞かせいただいたんですけれども、その現在起きている、まあ、ガザでの、まあ、戦争というよりもそのイスラエルのガザ侵攻、これがまあどのような形で終わるのかというのが、いくつかのシナリオを考えられると思うんですけれども、まあ、大使が考えるこの戦争の終わり方、どんなシナリオが考えられますか？
The Israeli scenario is very clear. And that is, there is no political outcome for the Palestinians. That means, there is no Palestinian state.
No state.
Whatever the outcome of Gaza, Israel continue on saying we will not allow a Palestinian sovereign state. What they are talking about, maybe bringing international policing force, bringing maybe multinational authority, maybe the governance of Gaza and other parts of the Palestinian territories by governors and not by the Palestinian Authority. And yesterday, the government of Israel announced clearly that they want to destroy the Palestinian Authority. And by destroying the Palestinian Authority, that means they want to destroy the Oslo Agreement and the PLO. So, in conclusion, the Israelis will not allowany positive result in the future for a Palestinian state. That means they want to continue their military occupation of Palestine. Why? They're making money. We buy from them electricity. We buy from them water. They take taxes on what we buy.
Business.
And it's business.
Business.
The occupation brings in,to the Israelis, billions of dollars a year. So the Palestinians are paying and being killed and paying for the Israelis. And the Israelis are making money. So there will be no peace. There will be no stability in the region as long as Israel continue its militaryoccupation of Palestinian territories and occupying over 6.5 million Palestinians. It's time to end it. What we Palestinians want is the end of Israeli military occupation according to international law and United Nations resolution, Security Council resolution, which is binding. Also, our independent country, independent state.Then we are free to do whatever we want in our country. Then we'll have elections, and whoever wins the election, the right, the left, the middle, the conservative, the liberals, it's the freedom that we have. It's the freedom of democracy. But apparently, Israel laws and Israel, what they want to enforce it not only on the Palestinians, but on the world. So now we are in a situation. Will the international community enforce their law on Israel, or will Israel enforce their laws on the international community and the world? And I have not seen through history that one country tells the world what to do. It's a rape country. It's a country that has rage in it. It is very clear that it has rage against the world.The whole world. Because now they're talking about a religion war. And that is no religion war. Nahna in Palestine, Christians, Muslims, Jews lived all their life together. until the Zionism came, until this colonialism people came, and the trouble started. They are the one who created this coal problem around in the Arab world, in the region, and around the world. Mm. And they have to, this has to be stopped.
Mm. 最悪ですね。もう本当にこんな軍事支配、軍事占領見たことない。
No, no, in modern history, no. The only control we had is the Nazis. The Nazis put the Jews in ghettos. Mm. The Israelis now are putting the Palestinians in ghettos. Mm. The Nazis were killing children and women. Today, Israel is killing women and children. Mm. Israel, Nazis destroyed Jewish areas. Mm. Today, Israel is destroying Palestinian areas. Mm. So, Zionism mm. and Nazism, mm. They're close to each other. Mm. Now, we are against the Holocaust. And we're not talking about the Holocaust, so I don't want anybody to say, mm. yeah, no, no. The Holocaust is one of the biggest crimes of the century. Mm. But today, Israel is committing another Holocaust mm. on the Palestinians. Mm. The victims of Europe are committing the same mistake that the European did against the Jews. Mm. And the Zionists today are committing the same problem and committing a Holocaust genocide, ethnic cleansing, and war crimes against the Palestinians. So Zionism has to be stopped. It is a virus that has to end and to be stopped. We have a lot of Holocaust survivors. Mm. They're talking, saying against Israel, what's committing in Gaza. Mm. We have a lot of Jewish communities around the world. They're demonstrating against Israel. Mm. We have a lot of Israelis and Jewish in Israel are demonstrating against the Netanyahu government. So, what it tells you? It tells you that there is no difference between a Christian, a Muslim, a Jew. And we are all humans. Forget the religion. We're at the end of humans. So the humanity of a lot of people that have suffered from the Nazis and suffered from Europe are feeling the same suffering that the Palestinians are suffering right now. So I think globally now, the people of the world are not supporting Israel. Mm-hmm. And it needs to continue that. Mm-hmm. Because Israel is not the Israel that we know. Mm-hmm. Israel right now is hijacked by the ultra-religious Zionist leaders, mm-hmm. you know, that do not believe in peace, and they believe in destruction for them to survive. Mm-hmm. And this government is a very dangerous government, not only in the region, but around the world. Mm. When you have leaders saying, we should nuke Gaza, mm. and when we have a senator in the United States yesterday or the day before says, we should give nuclear bombs to Israel so they can nuke Gaza like we nuked Hiroshima mm. and Nagasaki. Mm. These people are war criminals. Yeah. Those people has to be punished. No more. And the rule of law should be enforced on these people.
これ大使が持っているこのプランフォーポストガザ、このなんか内容がすごい気になるんですけど、これどういうことが書かれてるんですか？
It's a document done by Americans and Israeli military people. This kind of plan that they are writing, and it's made by 1, 2, 3, 4 U.S. generals and one Israeli. Colonel, this plan is to destroy the Palestinian statehood. The overview plan, too, it destroys the dreams of the Palestinians. That means there's no more Palestinian authority. Mm. They bring international police, mm. will take care of Gaza and the West Bank, mm. and the Palestinians have no more authority, mm. and Israel will control everything. Mm. It controls the border, the sea, the everywhere, mm. and we're still the same thing. But it starts all over again. Mm. For this is an outlook future view that Israel will continue occupying Palestinian territories for the next 100 years. Mm. And not only that, kicking Palestinians forcing them out of the land into countries around. So at the end, maybe in 10 years, there'll be no Palestinians left. But this is the dream. This is a... This is a stupid, idiotic dream that has no feeling for the people at all. Our aspiration cannot be destroyed by these people. A multinational authority overseeing an international contact group and including an international policing force to temporarily administrate Gaza, establish security, remove Hamas control, and start civil governance, start physical and social reconstruction, and says provide a better life for Gaza, culmination transition to local Palestinian governance and security responsibility once met. But if you go into deep into the project, it says here, legally, here, what they're saying is working closely with Israel and Egypt, but Egypt doesn't want to say. What they say here is not acceptable. They want from Australia, South Korea, Saudi Arabia, and Egypt, and this, you know, and they want to go to the United Nations and get a resolution to go, to over destroy all UN resolutions.
So,
between the lines, it's a complete change of law. It's not acceptable. This report has not come out yet. And I hope it will come out one day.
It's
311 pages. 311 pages. No, of course not. But this shows you that how the United States are saying something and doing something else. We want to stop the war. We want a two-state solution. Palestinians have the right to have a two-state, have their own state. But then they go and write these reports and these research. Ah, Palestinians don't deserve a two-state solution. No, no. Israel has to take everything. You know, so it's a double standard.
The double standard. We're bakageteru.
Bakageteru. And my friend, these times, you know, there is a saying that empires go up. But one day they have to go down. So, do we have to wait until the empires go down? The empire of the United States? The empire of Israel? Why not? We'll wait. We're resilient. Let me give you a simple example for your viewers about what is the problem in Palestine. Palestine was a land that has been over occupied by through the century. The last one was the Ottoman Empire. We had airport, we had ports, we had trains, we had Cadillacs, we had many cars. So Palestine was a country that was not has a lot of people. Economy, it was good economy in Palestine, but we still under Ottoman Empire. After the Ottoman Empire, the British came, as what they called the San Remo, and gave the British, it's called mandate. The British mandate is to protect the people and get them ready for their sovereignty and independence, not to occupy them. In Palestine, Jews, Christians, Muslims, others were living together. Actually, many were marrying from each other. There was no problem. Until the prosecution of the Jews in Europe. But the Jews in the Arab world and in Palestine and under the Ottoman Empire, they were living in peace. They were part of the society. So these refugees came from Europe to Palestine, refugees. So we opened up for the refugees. But these refugees started fighting us. Refugee in Japan does not have, as an example, does not have the right to buy land. Okay? They wanted to purchase land, and the British allowed them. They wanted to purchase more land. The British gave them okay. We were against it because refugee does not have the right to buy land in a foreign country because he's a foreigner. So they come in thousands, illegal refugees. Because the British allowed them, but we didn't allow them. Them were, they have weapons, and they had these terrorist organizations, the Haganah and the others, Jewish terrorist organization, started killing Palestinians. We started protecting ourselves. And imagine, you have your own house, and then somebody comes kick you out, a refugee, illegal refugee, comes, kicks you out, takes your home, and say, God gave me this house. Today, hundreds of thousands of these illegal refugees live in Palestinian homes that we built, that our grandfather built.
そうですよね。
I ask your audience, if somebody, refugee, takes your home, kicks you out, what will you do?
そういうことですよ。そういうことがもう毎日毎日ずっと何年間も、76年間も起きてきたということなんで、でもそれがほとんどのマスコミが報じてないんですよね。このイスラエル・ハマス戦争に関しては10月7日以降のことしか報じられてないんですよ。それ以前のこと、それでそこで何が起きてたのかっていうのがマスコミはもう口を閉ざしている。
76 years on the Nakba. Over 900,000 Palestinians were forced out of their homes by those refugees. You know, they claim that they were in the land 2,000 years ago, but my ancestors were there over 7,000 years ago. So who comes first?Then they say, God gave us this land. Oh, God. God is not a real estate company. He didn't say, this is Japan, this is China, this is Russia, this is Indonesia, Malaysia, this is Palestine. This is... No, he gave us the land for... We created those borders. We created that. So God has nothing to do with it. So this falsified historical history that they are doing,We have no problem with that. We, at the end, said, okay, you take 78% of the land. We accept 22% of the land. You, Israeli state, we, Palestinian state. We sign.
Yes.
But today, they said, no, all to, for us or nothing for you. So what shall we do? We have 6 million Palestinian refugees, 6 to 7 million refugees outside. UNRWA is taking care of 5.6 million refugees. Do these refugees have the right to return to their home? Do those refugees continue generation after generation after generation, and I'm one of them, as a refugee? I don't want to be a refugee anymore. I have a land. I have a country. I have the right to live in it. As much as they have the right.I accept the 22%. I'm not asking more. But give it to me. Leave us alone. Build the wall between us. I don't want to see you. Don't talk to me, you know? I want to live free. But it's my right. It's my right to have my own country. It's my right not to be a refugee. I don't want to be a refugee. I have...documents that goes back to almost 100 years that this land is mine, is my grandfather to my father to me. It's enough. I want to go home.
パレスチナ人はもういつまで我慢をし続ければいいのかっていうそういったことになってるわけですけど、これはぜひ皆さん真実を知っていただきたいと思います。現地で何が起きてるのか真実を知っていただいて、でそのためにも中日パレスチナ総代表部の X の方をぜひフォローしていただいて、現地で何が起きているのかというのを、できる限りリアルタイムで、情報収集して現実を知っていただきたいと思います。で現実を知ったら、少しでも声を上げて、いろんな方々に情報を発信して、でそして、日本の政府にも圧力を加えていくようなそういった動きになればなおいいかなと考えてますので、皆さんよろしくお願いします。中日パレスチナ総代表部の X の方もフォローよろしくお願いしますということで、こちら中日パレスチナ総代表部のワリド大使の方から今日お話しいろいろとお伺いいたしました。ワリド大使ありがとうございました。世界とつながりたいあなた、待ってます。